Hey everybody, welcome to an all-new episode of The Cineverse.
We're here at the Regency Theaters in Granada Hills, California.
Now tonight we're here to view the last movie of the 2011 summer blockbuster season, Conan the Barbarian.
We're gonna find out if this remake was worth being remade.
Let's go check it out.
This movie was so bad. First and foremost, this is an action flick, so directing it is more a matter of what looks cool rather than what looks right. Marcus Nispel can apparently do action, but not much else. Whenever a character is on screen and not killing someone, the direction suffers. It seems like Nispel got bored during these scenes, you know, uninteresting stuff like character development and plot. His direction also lacks style. These days, you can tell a lot about a movie just by knowing who the director is. Michael Bay has his explosions, J.J. Abrams his lens flares. Nispel, however, lacks something memorable in his technique. Aside from buckets of blood, that is. It seems as though he sought to make a Zack Snyder-esque film, but didn't have the patience to do it right. And consequently, the audience felt all 72,000 seconds of it. Yes, that's right. I counted them. There wasn't much else to do.
So, how did this movie look? I'd say barbaric. I mean, the practical sets were really old and rustic looking, which is kind of cool, and the costumes looked like they came from dragons and wizards. The locations were really cool, too. I mean, it looked like Homer wrote about them in one of his poems. You know, everything about this movie looked the part, except the CGI. It wasn't very realistic, but luckily the movie didn't rely too heavily on its use, and that was kind of nice to see. But the battle scenes were really cool. I mean, carnage and mayhem from every angle, blood splatters as far as the eye can see, a little equine distress, but really cool sword swinging. I mean, this all made Conan epically
bad!
Well, yeah.
Well, you know, this is Conan the Barbarian, so the acting was the last thing on anyone's mind. To be honest, the best was the narration delivered by Morgan Freeman at the beginning. From what I could gather, though, it seems as if the director looked at his performance and said, "All right. If you forget a line or you want to try something different, just lift your weapon above your head and scream." So they did. Suffice it to say, no acting accolades are heading Conan's way. But it seems as though the last actor to pick up the sword was Arnold Schwarzenegger, and there isn't much to live up to after that. All you had to do was get a really buff guy, check, and have him growl.
"I will follow you to hell."
Check. Remains of the day, it ain't, but it felt as if all the actors involved knew the kind of film they were in and acted accordingly.
You know, I'm actually not sure what to tell you. In fact, I don't really recall what the movie was about at all. I mean, I can tell you that Conan kills everything. And when he's not killing, he's running around going to kill or slay somebody or something for some inane reason. I mean, the plot itself is forgettable, obviously, but I cannot for the life of me remember the initial incident or turning point or the bloody climax, if in fact they were even in the movie to begin with. I mean, all I really remember is a lot of screaming and moaning and random weeping. And I'm quite sure that was just Dave sitting next to me.
So, Conan the Barbarian. Worth seeing?
No. It's bad. It's pretty bad. I mean, it's a B movie, so I wasn't expecting too much from it, but I got even less.
It was painful. This movie had to up the violence just to score its R rating, and even that wasn't entertaining enough to save it. I wouldn't matinee it. I wouldn't rent it. I wouldn't even watch it on TV if I was home sick, because it just might kill me.
I say Redbox DVD. Late Saturday night with some friends and a few stiff drinks. With nothing else to do, you might get some laughs.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Alright, well that wraps up this week's episode of The Cineverse.
For the full review of Conan the Barbarian, please check out our website.
And, like always, any comments, questions, or concerns, feel free to drop us an email.
And check us out next time for a review of Glumbiana and Don't Be Afraid of the Dark.
And, until next time, see you at the theater.